To be my hometown area where I grew up. And I got to tell you, I got the chance to hear Lee Byberg speak here just this last session. He came to our House Republican Caucus to speak. And what was remarkable to me is here is a man that signs the front of the check and provides jobs for citizens in the state of Minnesota. His kind of leadership is the kind of leadership that we need in Washington, not folks that have been there way past their prime. Please give a warm welcome to our 7th Congressional District candidate, Lee Byberg.
Thank you. America is a fantastic country. There's no place like it. I'm here to speak to you briefly about being part of a movement to restore freedom. I was born about 50 years ago now in America. After some time, my parents took me to South America where they served as missionary in Brazil and Paraguay, and I learned what it takes or what you experience when you don't have freedom. Later on, I grew up my teenage years in Norway, went to high school, and that's where I picked up the Minnesota accent. So as I lived the world, I learned that it is ingrained in all human beings to dream about freedom. It is just that not in every country is the dream as clear as it is in America. Yes, there's a dream in France, there's a dream in Germany, there's a dream in Russia. But let me tell you, over the ages, those that understood dreaming the clearest, they came to join you in America. Why? Because in the American dream, for the first time in history, people saw clarity that it is the Creator who has given us rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That's an idea that's more powerful than anything else seen in the history of mankind, that has taken millions of people and lifted them out of bondage and brought them to a course to opportunity and freedom. So when I came back to America as a young man, I was 20, I met for the first time young Americans. Let me tell you, this is in the early 80s. They had fire in their eyes. They also had something called a drive to succeed, to pursue. And I learned that in America, regardless of background, you can dream that you can do anything in life. You take your talents, you develop skills, and then you pursue your dream and you live life to the fullest. I have lived the American dream now for 30 years. I raised a family with my wife Nancy, and we have 3 sons. I'm a business leader of commerce. I led small companies with 25 people, young people, educated with science in the bioscience field, where we take their ideas and we try to rock the world with new innovation. I have also led mid-sized companies with 250 employees in the agricultural area. Now I'm talking about turkeys, and those in District 7, they know what I'm talking about. So my life has been free enterprise. I've been living the American dream. And then something happened a couple years ago. Senator Obama became our president. I got a call from a friend in Europe, and he asked me about this, and I said, I'm proud to be an American, but this will cost us more than we can imagine. Not just financially, but to the American dream. So I decided it's time to stand up as a business leader. and lead through a movement of farmers and business leaders, small business, medium-sized business, citizens coming together from our district in Minnesota as people who understand production, who understands productivity, who understands job creation, and we will stand up and rebuild America from the bottom up. Community by community, not from DC, but from home, from America, in our communities. I'm running against an incumbent, Representative Colin Peterson. He has been there for more than 20 years. He started out perhaps as a good person, but he's lost his way. He still talks about that he's moderate, but every time he does a major decision, what does he do? He imports East Coast, West Coast, DC values on top of your life in central western Minnesota. He started out with endorsing Nancy Pelosi, the Speaker of the House. She brought us Obama health care. Today he's refusing to repeal it. He tried to bring us cap and trade. He's endorsing the most liberal president in United States history. And President Obama, he's talking about transforming our nation. This is a time for us to rebuild our nation based on liberty, pursuit of happiness, and life itself. So the endeavor we are on together is superior, is bigger than life. It is about, again, leading for the next generation and reaching back to those principles of the past which are timeless, and they will be true for every generation that dares to dream that you got it in you. That you're made by your Creator with talents to add value. That it's up to you to develop those skills and then bring them home. So as we look at this race, Colin Peterson has become an importer of these values from DC, East Coast, and West Coast. This is a time for our in CD7 and Minnesota to export America back to DC so we can remain strong moving forward. So what I ask you to do in my closing moment, as we go into the fall, if you have fire in your eyes, if you have steel in your will, if you have love in your heart for freedom, stand with me, stand with us, and we will reach out to our neighbors and say that the American experiment is ongoing, and the next generation is ready to take on and stand in the gap for freedom so we can pass it on to the next generation. Thank you very much.